watch your lane, watch your hip, watch your lane. Now we're going to climb down this hill. We call this the Appian Way. This was actually a hill used in the movie Spartacus. Famous Hollywood legend. in the filming of the movie Spartacus, when they had to see with all the Roman soldiers running down the hill.
Now go to live cover on the scene as our helicopter reporter, Kelly King.
military comedies on my side, we have the body of water that was once the entire Pacific Ocean for the McHale's Navy TV series. Head start Ernest Borgnine, Tim Conway, Joe Flynn, Carl Ballantyne, Gavin McLeod, and the rest of the crew of the PT-73. Rumor has it that the crew of the PT-73 left exploding mines in the water. This is just a rumor. Don't take it too seriously. Quickly across the... Oh my goodness, what? Are we supposed to go here? It looks like they flooded the road on purpose. I tell you what, we need a little movie-making magic of our own. On the count of three, everyone say, part the waters. Ready? One, two, three. Going in unison, too. All right, let's see if it works.
Frankenstein movie, which was Frankenstein meets the Wolfman. That movie launched in
stage 50 houses the only two-level or double-decker set in Hollywood. That means there's a set built directly on top of another set. That's very rare, and we have a rare opportunity to visit these sets. We can take you through the lower level, which resembles a subway station. I do apologize that we can't take you upstairs to the city street level above, but right now the signs that say hot set basically are telling us we're not allowed to walk around and touch anything, so we have to admire everything from a distance. Well, take a look at the detail. You are here, man.
Ready? We're gonna
Kong's Animal House. You might recall John Belushi taking the ladder, climbing upstairs, peeking inside the upstairs window. Next door, we have Jimmy Stewart's home from the movie Harvey. Staying on Robert's side, the gray house with the white trim is 1313 Monster Landing, home for the Munsters. We've toned down the Gothic look, simply because nothing else can blend in with the rest of the American setting. The yellow house on Robert's side with the white trim, that was once the home of Lassie, when Lassie serves with Ewan the Stone and Christopher Stone. The house next door, kind of a beige color with the brick trim, that was the home of Doris Day and James Garner for the movie lived in almost every one of these houses, and she's had a different husband with each house. This is Anytown, USA. It's Mayfield from Leaf to Beaver, Cabotville from Mercy Road, Harper Valley from Harper Valley PTA. This area was also used in about 16 different episodes of One Leaf with Scott Bakula and Dean Stockwell. Each time, it was a different city in a different time period. But the sets are very versatile. The mansion could be a hospital or a sheriff's station. The little church could be a little schoolhouse. There's a few alterations here and there, a little paint here and there, and we have a completely different town. Most of the homes on Robert's Neck were with Tom Hanks and Carrie Fisher. In fact, Tom Hanks and Carrie Fisher lived in the Grand White House on Robert's side. Now, that house was featured in another Tom Hanks film, The Film was Dragnet. The house then was taken. It was home to Joe Friday's girlfriend. Vincent Price, you will always remember him for horror movies. He did hundreds. His first horror movie was done here on the Universal lot. It was called The Tower of London. So right about where the earthquake is now. When he made that movie, he said he would never, ever do another horror film again. That TV movie, The Bates Motel. Sets were also duplicated at Universal Studios, Florida, for the making of Psycho 4, The Beginning. That movie, by the way, was not only a sequel, it was also a prequel. Not only did you find out what happened after part three, you find out a lot of what happened before part one, like what were the circumstances that turned Norman Bates into the psychopathic killer that we all know and love today. Turns out it was his upbringing. As we make the turn, you can take a look at the Bates Motel. That's it. There's no interior. All the interior scenes were done inside of sound stages, with the exception of the made-for-TV movie The Bates Motel. That starred Bud Cort and Jason Bateman, and all the interiors for the Bates Motel movie were done in the Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. Did them all inside there. That's a practical set, just like this cabin on Robert's side. The cabin was originally built for The Great Outdoors with Dan Aykroyd and Jack Canty. Currently, they're working on an episode of Weird Science. Weird Science airs on the USA Television Network. Originally built for Jaws: The Revenge with Michael Caine and Lorraine Gary. Recently seen in both Waterworld and Apollo 13, we did the splashdown scenes. And only in Hollywood can we take you from sea level to ski level. We're at Timberline, 12,000 foot elevation. Because of the recent snowfall, we have to be extremely avalanche conscious. So you know what, I'm going to shut off the microphone because we don't want to make any noises that could set off an avalanche. The entertainment center for you. It's on your show schedule. You have those scheduled times. You want to go down to the studio center, just get on the Starway escalator. It's on the other side of Back to the Future. We'll lead you right down to the studio center, home to Backdraft, the World of Cinemagic, E.T., AT&T at the movies, and the Lucy tribute. If you're in the studio center,